All right, let's talk about this major headline now about the Pfizer vaccine for children and this new study that said it wasn't very effective after just a few weeks after all. What do you make of this?
I wonder if, first of all, I'm very sad to see that information. I wonder if the primary series for children is really going to be three doses and not two doses. Maybe they need that extra dose. What you and I are thinking about as a booster for adults is actually part of a primary series for children. When I think about the other vaccines we give to kids, like tetanus vaccine and pneumococcal vaccine, we give them three doses, not two doses. Yet in adults, we give perhaps one or even two doses. Maybe kids need three doses. Remember, the dose that was picked, we wanted a lower dose to make sure that we saw no events of myocarditis, that heart inflammation. And in fact, we're not seeing it in the younger kids because of that low dose. Perhaps though, kids need three doses and not two. And I expect both Pfizer and Moderna are going to make sure what the right schedule is before they get their EUA approval.
Do you think there's a possibility too that the dosage, even the first and second dose, that amount could be tweaked now in light of these new results?
The answer is I don't know. I think that Pfizer is going to have to investigate that. Moderna is going to have to check what's the right dose that they should use. And until we know that information, we're going to have to say, get the vaccine that's available now that may be tweaked in the future. I think the other choice of getting no vaccine is probably not the best of choices.
Okay, so experts in the field like yourself who are trying to encourage parents to get their children vaccinated are now going to have to deal with this latest set of data here to overcome some of that hesitancy. Because as you well know, the hesitancy among parents is larger than if it were just among adults making that decision for themselves. So what do you say to parents now who are looking at those numbers and saying, I don't know about this?
First of all, I think that the companies are studying it. So the fact that they don't know and we don't know means that we will have to find the information out. But I get back to thinking about what is the vaccine for? Is it preventing the cold or the coronavirus having that early illness event? Or is it really preventing those hospitalizations? And for that reason, I do think that the vaccine is still a reasonable choice. Betting that we won't get another variant, I don't want to take that bet at all. I think we need more information about the vaccine. We probably will need to give three doses. I don't know that we're going to have to give a higher dose, but we're going to have to study that information before we have a final outcome. But on the other hand, saying, oh, COVID is finished, we're not going to have any more variants, masks are off, we're done, that's just not true.
The timing of this study, seeing the light of day, coinciding with the removal of some of those mask mandates, is that concerning to you? That maybe the children who are vaccinated don't have the type of protection without the mask that we thought they did even a week ago?
So I wish I had an answer for that, and I don't. I think it is a concern. I think taking off masks is always a concern when we have an infectious virus floating around our communities. On the other hand, right now, our infection rate is quite low, and I think that's good. We have to pay close attention to it, though. We can't afford to say, oh, it's under 2%, oh, we're done. I think we have to see what happens now when the masks come off. Are we going to see a surge in kids? Maybe the protection we need is going to be masking for a bit longer in our children. I wish I had an answer right now. I don't, but except to say that we have the ability to figure it out over the next few days and weeks.
And you're someone who's looking at this from a scientific point of view. You study the data, you make decisions based on that. But for the folks who are actually making the decisions about whether the mandate should go or not, they've got to consider public opinion. They've got to consider the politics of this. Are there concerns from your perspective that maybe that balance is not what it was, say, 6 months to a year ago?
I think the balance has shifted because Omicron came and left. And people are saying, okay, it's not Delta, it's not killing people left and right. On the other hand, Omicron, for those who are not vaccinated, particularly the adults, was still a deadly disease. So I don't know what the next few days will bring, except to say we have to keep our eyes open. We have to look what happens. And the other thing is to respect the parents that say they still want their kids masked. Just because the mask mandate is lifted doesn't mean that you are not allowed to wear a mask. I think there will be a lot of parents whose kids have either medical issues or someone in the family has a medical issue who are going to ask their children to please continue to wear a mask in school. We have to respect those parents and not shame the kids for wearing a mask.
And also, it doesn't have to be mask all the time or mask never again, right? There's a middle ground there depending on where you are and where you're going with your kids.
Right, and I think about our children who have cancers in the past. There were times when they always wore their mask in school, and there were times when they didn't need their mask in school. And then they had to circle back and put their masks back on. We should never have made fun of them in the past or shame them, and the same applies now. If a kid is wearing a mask sometime and not other time, they should still be allowed to do so.